Hey everybody, thank you very much for coming out on this cold Saturday morning. I'm Eric Lohnes, I'm a policy analyst with the Freedom Foundation. And Freedom Foundation. So, as I was preparing my notes for this event, I couldn't help but think of a certain irony that's going to take place on the Capitol campus. And actually, you hear it taking place behind me right now. As you may have heard, and now you see, the people who are on the other side of this issue, Washington Federation of State Employees and Company, have prepared a rally and are counting our rally, which is Justice for Taxpayers. I came across one of their email notifications yesterday asking their members to rally on behalf of state workers. The notification asked their members to meet at 10 a.m. for breakfast and coffee for training before they marched down here so their voices could be heard. So, remember, we're talking irony here. So the plan is to march down here to protest our rally. But before the protesting begins, they're going to have a nice warm breakfast and that's paid for by the union. Who can blame them? Everybody likes breakfast. They're going to have nice warm coffee that's paid for by the union. Again, who can blame them? Everyone loves coffee. This is Washington State. They're going to do that to come down here and demand more money from you, the taxpayer. And as I was thinking about this, it occurred to me how generous you people are. I mean, you already know you're generous, but you guys are generous beyond your own comprehension. And I'll explain a little bit. So who bought the breakfast for him? You did. Who bought the coffee for him? Yeah, you guys got it. You're on a roll. Who bought the green and now I see yellow shirts that they're using to march down here and make their point? The taxpayers did. You, hard-working taxpayers, went out, got jobs, got your businesses, created income and revenue that you now then split between yourself and the government. You paid taxes. Now, a portion of that money went to the government to run government operations, and a portion of that that went to government operations went to pay for state employee salaries. Then, some of that went to state employee salaries was forcibly taken from the state employees, which was then given to them via coffee and breakfast this morning. So, just again, I want to thank you guys for your generosity. You're very generous beyond your own understanding. So, that point being made, it was partially in jest, but it underscores a very important thing that is often forgot here in Olympia. And that's simply that government operations wouldn't happen without the taxpayer. None of this. Government wouldn't function without you. You are the linchpin that holds all this together, and you're constantly despised and forgotten. They clearly don't appreciate you behind me. Yet you guys are the ones that make what they're doing right now happen. Olympia does have a problem. It's not a revenue problem, it's a spending problem. And that's the problem that needs to be addressed. Now consider. Since the current 2009-11 budget was enacted in 2009, the state legislature has passed and the governor has signed four supplemental budgets. The most recent one having been signed February 18th, which was last week. Yet there still remains $160-ish million they need to close in the current budget. Now, even to get to that point, to where they still need to cut $160 million in the current budget, they've relied on a number of budget gimmicks, including reliance on one-time federal dollars, fund transfers from dedicated accounts, and the strong possibility they're going to kick about between $200 and $250 million of debt they owe in the current budget to the next budget to make us liable for it tomorrow. We are in a crisis. And the picture going forward doesn't look much better. In fact, it looks worse. Once Washington's elected officials patch up the current budget, they have to deal with a $5 billion-ish budget deficit in the next budget. The current budget problem pales in comparison to the $5 billion problem they have to deal with next budget. But it gets worse. Just wait. And yet our long-term prospects are even more dismal than the $5 billion budget. The budget path we are currently running down is a dead end. Our state has continued to increase spending, has continued to extend lavish benefits to state employees and is now facing a much larger structural budget deficit over the long run to the tune of $40 billion. And yet, these problems before us, our elected officials have continued to raise state spending each year and still plan on raising state spending next year. This is a problem. Our state is in financial straits, and that labor unions and their allies in the legislature have continued to insist on raising your taxes to solve the problems that they've created. Enough will never be enough for them. It's time to take our stand and declare justice for taxpayers. Thank you.